All right, guys, how are you guys doing today? Hopefully everybody is doing great, right? Today I'm going to be talking about veganism. I noticed a lot of vegans are going back to eating meat, right? My channel is multi-purpose, like I always mention, so I touch upon a little bit of everything, right? I go into, you know, health and wealth, martial arts. I do some tutorial videos on martial arts. How to fix your phone, your blender, tutorials, how to do's, veganism, prediction videos, analysis work, you know, predicting fights, the outcome, breakdowns of fights. So, you know, I take a look at everything because all the things that I talk about, you know, I make videos on is because I have experience in it. That's the reason why I'm able to can do that. That's why I make my channel multi-purpose, right? So, like, veganism is concerned, no, the word vegan, no, right, is not a term that I like to use for myself. I mean, if you ask me a question or you ask me, hey, you know, do you eat meat or you're vegan, plant-based, whatever, whatever, sometimes I like to use the word plant-based because vegan, no, is something where, especially in these times, no, it's like a trend. Right, people are just doing it because it's kind of cool, I guess, or it's different. And sometimes they will do it for a year and two, and then they go back to their regular lifestyle, doing whatever they were doing from before they were vegan, right? So I like to use the word more plant-based, raw foods, which for myself, I've started this journey, it's a lifestyle change, actually. Sort of way back in 2012, which I've documented with my Instagram, which I'm going to show you some pictures. Like I said, I've learned something through my years recently too, that, you know, if you're going to do anything, always do it for yourself, right? Please yourself. Because if you think about it, you're wasting your time, wasting energy trying to please other people. And other people might not have the same mindset like what you have. You know, the mindset might be on different things. You know, everybody is different in mindset, mentally. Physically, you know, we're basically the same. Heartbeat, blood, bones, cells, brain, you know, two legs, two arms. Basically the same, but mentally, we could be different. A lot of us are different, right? So, like I said, always try to please yourself first. You know, do for you, man. Because at the end of the day, that's all you're going to have is yourself. And this is true meditation. When you're meditating by yourself, love yourself. That's basically it. You know, and once you love yourself, then everything will flow into place. Right? So as far as the vegans, going back to eating meat, whatever, you know, this lifestyle here, going vegan, raw food, etc., vegetarian, is not an easy lifestyle, you know, because if you remember, it depends on how you are raised too. If you wasn't raised vegan, you were raised on eating meats, you know, pork, chicken, you know, Christmas dinners, you have the pink ham, you know, fish and all these things. If you were raised like that, which I was, you're gonna have up and downs, man. You know, some, you know, you might try it for a year and then on the side you might eat a little chicken here and there because you feel like you need the protein from the chicken, you feel like you need the protein from the steak. You know, you feel that you need more iron and etc., right? Or B12, right? So, you know, you're going to go back and forward and dibble-dabble, you know, which I did, you know. When I started this back in 2012, yeah, on the side, I was eating little eggs here and there, little chicken wings, you know, fish I was eating too, because I felt like I needed that. I needed the protein and all these B12s and all these things. But eventually, along the way, I started to get better at it. You know, and right now I'm like 85% raw, and then the other percent is vegan, right? So raw meaning that I've just consumed a lot of more raw foods, basically, like fruits raw, bananas, juices, smoothies, nuts and seeds, and then the other vegan side there, I might have some cooked food here and there. It all depends. You know, and the activities that I'm doing, that's the thing with a lot of vegans that are trying this out for the first time are going to be a vegan for the first time. You can see a lot of them only done it for 2 or 3 years and then they quit. I've been doing this from 2012, and where we are now, we're 2019, so that's a good, what, 7 years, going to be 8. So I'm doing this for a little while now, and yeah, it's not easy. Even depending on your activity, and how much you consume on a daily basis. If you're gonna go vegan and you're going raw, you have to consume a good amount of food, man. You have to consume, man. If you're not consuming, and depending if you're gonna exercise, you could be weak, right? And it's just like the same thing when you talk about your levels are high or low on a animal protein lifestyle. Eating steaks and ham and all these things and chicken and stuff like that, you get diabetes, high blood pressure. It can work the same way, say if you're raw or vegan, just like if you're eating meats and animal protein, your levels go high. When you're vegan and raw, your levels can go low. So you can have low blood pressure, you can have low blood sugar. So you have to make sure that you're consuming a lot of food consistently, depending on what you're doing too. Like for myself, I'm an athlete. I'm very athletic, and I've been training martial arts for all my life, and still competed all my life too. So I have to make sure that, like, when I'm going to exercise now, I don't like to exercise enough on a, like I say, a full stomach, which my stomach is hardly ever full. Because I don't eat to fool my belly. When I eat in, because it's fueling my mind, my brain. And my brain would tells me when, okay, I'm good enough now, which I don't need to eat like that. Because you shouldn't eat until your belly is full. So I like to just, maybe have some dates, some bananas, some fruits. Then I go work out, right? But when I come back, I try to fuel up back. I would like some plant protein milkshakes, which is made out of almond milk. I will have, like, maybe some mushrooms, falafels, some quinoa. I might have some chickpeas, black beans, mushrooms mixed in there. I might make a sandwich, a vegan patty, vegan burger mixed in there, which is mixed in with like lentils, black beans, falafels, like chickpeas mixed in there, and I have that in a sandwich, or I could have it in a lettuce wrap, so it, depending on the workout I'm doing, I always try to fuel back up my body, right? And when I'm not working out, which I'm always working out, but if I'm taking a day or two off, I might go a little lighter with just more juices and smoothies, become just on a chill vibe. But when I'm gonna push the envelope now and go hardcore, I make sure I fuel up. And this consists of, like I said, protein shakes, but plant-based everything. A lot of nuts and seeds, a lot of chickpeas, black beans, quinoa mix in there. I have tofu from time to time, portobello mushrooms, But those are when I'm working out and when I'm gonna hit it hard, because I sweat a lot, I perspire a lot, and I can shed water weight in a day easily. 2 hours, I can drop 10 pounds of water weight easily. So if I go in the gym, say at 175, when I'm finished working out, I can come out at 165 easily, 10 to 15 easily, right? So it's a lifestyle where it's a tricky thing, and you have to know what you're doing, or else you can drop your levels, right? You can have very low levels, man, to where you feel like you're gonna pass out, because you're not fueling your body properly, right? Show you some pictures here, which you guys probably were looking at. This is way back here. This is when I had a bald head. This is 2013. This is where I already started my lifestyle. I started from 2012, so I already started my lifestyle. This is the first picture I post, 2012. Right, I already kind of started everything, and this is the path that I was going on, because the lifestyle that I was living from before, it was unhealthy for me. I felt sick on that lifestyle. Like I said, I started way back in 2012 because of my issues I had, from hypertension, high blood pressure, digestive problems, stomach swole up, didn't use the toilet for like 3 4 days, almost a week, because I was backed up. All of the foods I've been consuming from a younger age, which, like I mentioned, when I was younger, I never really used to eat that much anyway. I really ate very small portions of food, but as I get older, when I hit like 15, 16, 17, into my teenager years, I started to eat more heavy foods, like the heavy meats, red meat, pork, goat, and then I started drinking hardcore. At 20, was it 20, 21? I started drinking hardcore and got into the drinking thing, big time. Party for like good 10 years straight, just drinking and a bunch of other different things. So, that take a toll on your body, right? So, like around what, I believe it was like 31, 32, my body start to talk to me. It start to tell me, hey, you need to make a change. Either make a change or you're gonna end up on prescription drugs. And you're gonna be going to the doctors every day, and they're gonna give you all different kind of prescription drugs that don't work, and it's gonna give you a bunch of other problems. So you can start working on yourself from now, or you can wait until later on where you're gonna have a bunch of problems. So, like you see here, the picture on the left side, I was like 2010, 2011. You can see I was kind of putting on weight. And I was putting on a lot of weight here, feet were swollen, and this is not from sitting down now. Sometimes when you sit down for too long, if your feet can swell, but this is just from standing up. Foot were swollen, I looked chunky, I looked like I was retaining a lot of water here, right? Picture on the right here, I started to work on myself. This is like 2012 now, working on myself, lost a lot of weight, dropped 30 pounds. Picture on the left, I was 200, dropped down to 170. So I was working out hard, and I was on my lifestyle change. So I was mostly consuming here just raw foods, smoothies, juices. That's it. Water. I wasn't really eating anything much, right? So I kept on that vibe, and I lost a lot of weight. Felt good. My ankles went down. My blood pressure went all the way down. No more blood pressure problem. What else did I have? My gallbladder. I had some kind of issue with my side, which was probably causing my digestion problems with the bloating stomach, and wasn't able to use the toilet. I had like a pain up in my right side there, which I had a herbalist told me that that was my gallbladder, so I had to go work on that. So he just told me to basically eat more fruits and vegetables, basically. When I was like, what? That is what kind of brought on the change. When he was telling me to eat more fruits and vegetables, I was like, what? Because I never used to eat fruits and vegetables. So I just ate pure heavy food, steaks and pork and all these things, because I felt like that's the protein. So when he told me to do that, I was like, man, this guy's crazy. I'm not gonna eat just fruits and vegetables, man. And he mentioned to me to eat a little fish too, but I was like, man, that's crazy, man. And sure enough, man, a week passed by, freaking pain was killing me, man, because I kept on eating the same kind of foods. Eating the pork, chicken, and there was just one more night that I ate like that. Man, the food was in my throat. My body wasn't able to digest that food anymore. My body wasn't able to break down the animal protein anymore. My body couldn't do it no more. I reached that point now where I was stacking on weight. My body wasn't able to break it down. And it was just sitting right in my throat, on my chest. And my stomach would just swell up. And I would just lay in bed. Couldn't lay down flat on my back because it just hurts. I had to sit up in the bed, like moaning. Ah, felt like throwing up. Couldn't use the toilet. I felt like I needed to use the toilet, but I couldn't. And then days go by. Imagine 3 4 days go by. I ate a freaking goat and pork and steaks, and it's in my system for 3 4 days. And I don't pass it out. That's where you have all kind of problems. That's where you get cancer, colon cancer, and all these things. That's where the cancer come from. Okay, you're not. Whenever you eat something, when you put it into your mouth, you should release it that same day. No, when I eat anything, same day comes right out, like clockwork. I have no problems with toilet action at all. My toilet action is good now, every single day, no problem. Right? So that's the picture on the left. And then that's when I made the change. Picture on the right, lost all that weight, felt good, mentally clear, Again, you have ups and downs because you're the only person that's living this lifestyle among your whole family, who's nobody else is doing it except for you. So you're like an outcast. So, you hear things in the ears all the time. People, oh, where you get your protein from, this and that. And, it could mess with your mind. So, 2012, I would like go back and eat a little fish here, chicken here, mostly eggs here. But then I would realize, man, after I ate that, I don't feel good. My body wouldn't feel good. I would feel close to what I felt like in the beginning, before I started to go vegan, So I was like, man, I feel like I'm going backwards. Like I say, man, I can't do this. I have to eat the way how I'm eating now, that raw plant-based lifestyle, because that's working for me. So it's like I'm going away from what's working for me, going right back into where I was before in the slums. So I'm like, nah. Like, I'm not going to do that, man. I'm going to stick to plant-based, and I dropped everything. Also, the alcohol, too, was the next problem. I was just so hyped on alcohol, which I never liked alcohol. I never liked the taste of it. I only did it because it gave me a buzz. It gave me that, I guess you can feel a tipsy feeling, because it's like a social thing, because I was a very shy person, and I had a hard time talking, so when I drink alcohol, it would loosen me up. I feel nice and mellow, and I could go out there and dance and have a good time and feel relaxed, and then all the ladies come around, right? So I was just using the alcohol like a crutch, just for more of a relaxation thing. So then I started push over to red wine, because I thought red wine was more, healthy thing. But I was wrong. When you're drinking a whole bottle of red wine, that's the worst hangover. Worst hangover ever. Worst hangover. You're better off drinking three beers, three bottles of Heineken, than go drink a whole bottle of red wine. It's the worst hangover ever. I drank red wine one more time. Worst hangover, stomach bloated up, felt like crap. After that day, I said, I'm done. Never touch red wine again. I said, if every time I drink and I feel like this, this can't be good. Everything that I put into my system that wasn't healthy or a natural feeling, it will trigger my stomach to react in a kind of funny way. Like my stomach would bloat, belly ache, my side would hurt, like where my gallbladder is. So once I took out the alcohol, took out all the animal products, it was like a brand new man. Brand new man. You can look at my hair, kind of way I was kind of losing the side of my hair. I know a lot of vegans, the ones who are going back to meat, they're saying, oh, my hair is falling out, my teeth is chipping. I'm not going to name any names now. I'm not putting anybody on Front Street. But I'm just saying, for me, my hair grew back, right? And you could tell I had low cut hair because I was shaving my head. But if you can look at my head in the side here, if you can see where the arrow is pointing, I was going bald in the sides of my head. That's why I was starting to shave my head. So this is all on animal products now. I was raised like this. I'm born in Jamaica. We were raised and eating goat, pork, and all these things. When I was a younger kid, I never used to eat much of that stuff, though. I used to eat more sweets. Once I started getting older, like 15, 16, that's when I started to indulge in the food, right? So like I show you here, I was losing my hair, right? Going forward now, I start to grow my hair out. And my flexibility, I kind of lost it a little bit. I felt a little bit more, tight. After 2011, my whole body started to break down on me. Like, I never felt as flexible as I used to before when I was younger. Felt a little more tight or stiffer in certain areas. So I said to myself, man, I'm doing something wrong here. It could be the way I was eating, the drinking. And as I said, I went to a herbalist doctor and kind of helped me out, led me on the right path. So as you can see here, all the fruits, vegetables, all the smoothies I was making here. This is my journey. This is 2013. I document this stuff here for me to go back and look. Like I said, when you're doing anything, learning now, do it for yourself. The only person you can help is yourself. And once you help yourself, everything else will flow. Right? It's cool to give people tips and all this good stuff, but again, people are going to do what they want to do, man. You know, everybody have a mind for themselves, and they're going to do what they want to do, right? So you can see all the pictures here. Picture here with me, shaved head again, because losing my hair, so I was starting to just shave it bald. My skin came back, complexion, my skin, my look, actually. I look a lot younger now than I do when I was in 2010. So my aging process has slowed down a lot. Actually, it reversed. Sounds kind of strange I said that, but it actually reversed. So you can see here, you know, the process is going along. I start feeling more comfortable with myself. Then I'm going to start growing my hair out now. Like I said, I use these things to help people, but it's merely for myself. So I can go back and look. You can see my body, very ripped. Not much body fat in me. So you can see all the food I've eaten here. Like I said, it's not an easy lifestyle, and you need to eat. You need to consume. If you're eating raw, you need to consume. Eating vegan, you need to consume. And again, remember, when it comes to veganism, when you're vegan, it's not everything that a vegan's going to eat is going to be healthy. Because like I said, you have the vegan patties that have a lot of ingredients in them. You know, soda is supposedly vegan, but you know, I don't drink soda, right? It's not good for you. So there's a lot of things that consume, you know, say a vegan might eat, a lot of fry products and all those things, is not good for you. A lot of the, like, you know, the stuff that is like soy based, you know, like they call chicken or whatever, which I don't eat much of that either. That's not good for you either. So you have to be careful, because you can be vegan and eating all these things, but eating unhealthy vegan food, which can make you sick too and make your levels low and all these things, right? So you have to be very careful. That's why I like raw. And that's why I say I'm 85% raw and the other rest is vegan, or depending on my exercises, my workouts. I could work out on raw too, you know, but like a supplement, a lot of plant-based protein shakes, and I eat a little quinoa, black beans, falafels, which is chickpeas, and I might have a little bit of mushroom, I might have mushrooms mixed in there, so like a variety, you know, I kind of balance it out like that. How my flexibility came back, I started doing more yoga, everything was just starting to flow, everything just coming back. I felt like I was like 10 years old again. Wasn't competing against anybody else. I'm just challenging myself. So all these things that you see, I'm challenging myself so I can go back and say, all right, I did this today, I'm going to do something else. See all the foods I'm eating here. This is a good little salad here, quinoa. You got spinach, kale in there, tomatoes. You got edamamas in there. raisins, you know, so it's a good little thing here. So you have to eat, man. A lot of vegans that went back to meat now, they're saying that, oh, my teeth chip, my hair falling out. But guess what? I only been to dentist twice in my whole life. Twice. And that's when I came to the States. And I went the first time for the dentist to x-ray my mouth and, you know, kind of assess what's wrong with my mouth so you can do work on it as far as fillings, which I feel that the dentist messed up my mouth a little bit though. You know, because sometimes they drill too much. They drill down in your teeth and they go too deep down where they, you know, they start to hit nerve and you don't want that. You know, so when they're drilling down there and putting all these fillings in your mouth, they're kind of messing up your mouth like that. Right? And I have no problems with my teeth. My teeth are straight. Everybody always asks me, man, have you wore braces before? I'm like, no, my teeth was always straight like that. You know, I've been to dentist twice. I need to go back though to remove some fillings and then, you know, do a little cleaning here and there. But overall, I have no problems with my mouth though. So this is going to be my third time going to go to the dentist. But I'm going to a holistic dentist though. Right, the first time I went to a dentist because I was young, I didn't know. My parents took me, but I'm going to a holistic, just do some cleaning, and do some filling here and there, and that's it. You know, I'm actually gonna do some work on what the dentist did prior. You know, because I felt like he messed up my mouth, but I'm gonna go to the holistic dentist and have her do some work on my mouth, which is not much, very little, right? Yeah, so you see here, you know, just pictures of me just from way back. It's my hair is growing the hair out. Soursop, which is very good fruit, good for everything. Avocado is a good source of fat. Yeah, so my hair is growing back out and everything. Everything start to look good, slim and trim. Yeah, so that's basically it. It's a tricky thing, because just like how you're eating animal products, your levels go up. Your levels can go low when you're vegan, and a lot of times you might not feel as good. At least some vegans don't, you know what I mean? And then they start like, oh man, I'm gonna start going back to eating meat because I felt better on meat or whatever. But again, on my journey, you know, growing up, you know, when you're younger, you're moving all the time. You're very, you know, athletic. You're working out. When you're young, kid, you're running up and down the place. You know, once your metabolism starts to slow down, you know, the foods that you're consuming, you know, will do damage to you, especially if you're consuming animal products on a consistent basis like that, right? So it can do damage to you, especially if you're not moving as much as you used to, you know? So again, like I said, man, I'm just making this video just to show my experience, just to show my journey. You know, I'm not here to honestly tell anybody what to do. Because at the end of the day, you're going to do what you want to do. See my hair kind of growing back out. Now, this is when I'm starting to work on my dreads now. Because my hair is growing back out, right? So, you know, I'm not here to tell you, oh, do this, do that. You do what works for you. As for me, you know, it's a lifestyle. It's a life journey. And I've picked up a lot of things along the way. And I've learned different things to incorporate into my lifestyle to help me. And like I said, I'm very athletic. I'm always working out, so I need to fuel. You need to fuel. So you need to put back in whatever you're gonna sweat out. And I say I sweat a lot. So if I don't put back in whatever I sweat out, I have low blood sugar. You start getting the shakes and all these things, and your body will trip out on you. Your levels will go low. But if you're consuming, and you eat, consume. If you're eating raw, you eat. And you know when to eat, especially if after your workout, you have to consume. You have to consume. As long as you're consuming, you're good. And like I said, I supplement. I might do a B12 here. And then I have my protein plant-based shake, which has a lot of different minerals and vitamins in it. So I consume that, right? A good little salad here. Alfalfa sprouts. Chickpeas, mushrooms, beets. This is actually raw, because everything here is raw. All the mushrooms is raw, everything here, right? Like I said, I like raw because it's just the way you feel when you're on raw, man. It's like there's nothing like it, right? This is also raw too. Well, actually, hold on there. No, the pasta and the red peas is not. But this is a good little salad here, right? Yeah, so that the hair is growing out now, start feeling better, everything start to go away, you know, the blood pressure gone, the gallbladder pain gone, the stomach shrink all the way down, start to see more ribs, a lot more muscles showing now, drop off all that weight, no more stomach problems, no more head problems, starting to feel good, feel excellent, no problems at all. This is 2014, so it didn't take me long. It took me maybe 6 months to a year till I start feeling a difference. So yeah, a good 6 months to a year before I start feeling a difference. I felt great. Yeah. And yeah, going by. all the way through. We see the dreads start to come out now. See the dreads start to come out. Start to feel good. It's working out, man. All this is just part of my journey, man. You know, I'm trying to get myself back. You know, I'm practicing my yoga here. All the way through. All the way through. You know, like I said, my mishaps, I went back and forward, was basically maybe a month or two in 2012. You know, I had a little eggs here and there because I was just unsure, because starting up a new lifestyle like that, you know, you're not eating meat, which is something that you were told to eat. You know, meat has protein, milk from the cow, you know, calcium, good for your bones and every teeth and all these things, which all that stuff, the milk, every time I drank milk, my stomach would swell up because I was lactose intolerant. So lactose intolerant meaning that the milk don't belong in you. That's just basically it. It's not that you're lactose intolerant, it's just that you're not supposed to be drinking cow milk, basically, right? So, you know, I don't know, man. Like I said, I'm here, you know, to spread my knowledge, you know, spread my experience, but at the same time, I'm here to work on myself. So just like all of us are here, you know, everybody have their journey in life that, you know, that they have to go through. And like I said, you have to figure it out. And, you know, I could give you hints here and there, give you tips and stuff like that, but I'm not going to tell you what to do. And as far as vegan is concerned, you know, yeah, cruelty to animals, which I understand that, you know, the slaughterhouse and all these things, it's the way how they do the animals, they butcher them horribly. And the way how they kill them, you know, the animals is dying out of fear and everything, and then you're going to turn around and eat that. And sometimes they pump up the animals, well, not sometimes, majority of the time they pump them up with chemicals and steroids and all these things, and you turn around and eat that. So, again, guys, I mean, you do you. Planet is dying, just like how we all are dying too. You know, the human body will decay, go back into the earth, you know, but the way how they treat the planet, the environment, pollution in the air, just by driving the cars around, just doing a lot of damage to the earth, right? Killing the earth, killing the planet. The planet is dying. So at the end of the day, just do the best you can. You know, you do for you. There is some times after the year I would just go strictly raw for years, for like maybe 1 or 2 years, and I would go back, you know, and 85% raw, and the other percentage I just go back vegan again. It's like a bean dish, broccoli, carrots, mushroom dish there. Like I said, my flexibility was just amazing. Like I was more flexible now than I was when I was a young kid. That's amazing. So up in my 32, 33, 34 lifetime, when I was young, like 10, 11 years old, I'm more flexible now than I was back then. So it's not easy though. It's a lot of work, and it's worth it because it's your health. You know, health is wealth. Nothing else matter, man. I'm telling you. You know, you can have all the money you want, you know, and all the girls or whatever you want, but if your health ain't right, yeah, no girl gonna be around you. No girl is not gonna wanna be around you. Or you won't be able to pick up any girl because you'll be sick every day. Right? And if you ain't feeling well, no matter how much money you have, you're not gonna be able to spend the money, and you're gonna be taking the money and going to the doctors them that's gonna be pumping you up with pure chemicals. And giving you wrong advice, man. You know, I mean, it is what it is, man. Like I said, I feel that, well, what I've learned is that sometimes we don't have the answers then to everything, you know, and sometimes it even shows it in the medical industry. Sometimes a lot of the medicine them that they're giving the people, they don't know if it's going to work or not. It's like a trial and error. It's like they're testing it out on you. And if it works in some kind of way where it might mask some kind of symptoms and you feel a little better at that point. But I don't think it really cures you, and it doesn't. You know, so you got to get to the root of the problem. right? And that's the thing, you're not getting to the root of the problem. I got to the root of my problems. My problems was just basically I consume too much alcohol, which had a lot of basically sugar in it, like especially the Hennessy, the brown liquor. And I was drinking that with soda way back, right? And like just killing the juices, the alcohol, the red wine. And then on top of that, I would just eat pure chicken and pork and stuff like that. And so that was my problem, you know, the alcohol, drinking, not taking care of my body properly. So I had to get to the root of the problem. And once I got to the root and I see what it is and I say, all right, this is the problem, then I go work on it. I go tackle it, right? So these are photos from 2015 now. So these are way back, it's a couple years back. You see me doing my stretching and doing my splits and everything like that. So I'm showing you some old pictures here. And strictly raw, no problem. Smoothies, juices, doing my kicks, everything. I'm going to show you, you know, what I'm still doing right now. Right? This is me back at American Top Team, you can tell. I had a little belly growing. You can tell my neck is a little swollen there. Right? A lot of water retention there. You can tell my hair on top here. It's kind of slightly receding here on one side, recedes a little bit more, right? Not healthy right here at all. This side, no, right side, slim down, raw vegan lifestyle, plant based, felt good. Dreads growing out. This is when I did my 20 pounds I lost in 20 pounds I lost in a day. Yeah, dropped down from 175 to 155, I believe. Was it this side here? 155 to 175. Yeah, from 170 to 155. It's me just doing a split. This is 216. Yeah, it's 216. More flexible here than... I'm more flexible here than I was ever been when I was a young kid. Way more flexible. Especially when I incorporated the yoga. Whew. So just keep on going here. I'm always working out here, just doing my thing. All the way through, this is just my documents, guys. You know, I do this to help people, and most important thing, to help myself. Always help yourself. Never point fingers at nobody and say, oh, because of you, you made me like this, or made me did this. You know, always look into yourself and then you work for, you work on yourself, pull out from what's inside of you and bring it into reality. You know, just work on yourself. It's good food here, good source of fats, some omega-3s there, the walnuts, some avocados, good source of fat. Have some strawberries, I believe that's some raspberries there. It's a good little salad there. So keep going here. It's a more recent picture here. This is April of last year. Just showing you, you know, from the past, pictures from the past there. Still doing my yoga. This is 2018. Still doing my yoga same way. Still doing my stretches on the pole. Still doing my jump flying kicks. This is from 2020. This is like basically 6 years ago. Still doing the same thing. Still feeling good. It's gonna just jump all the way through to 19 now. Still do my stretches on the tree. Even better stretches on the tree. Better than I did back in 2012. I did a split like this back in 2012, which I showed way back. It's way better now, and I'm gonna be 40. I'm gonna be 40 in a couple of days, and look at that. Look how flexible I am now. Still, right? Better actually, better. Still doing my kicks. Still doing my splits. I believe I have a split video here somewhere, or more recent one. This is me recent. It's like 2018 last year. Still doing the splits and the countertops. So, I guess again, everybody is different, I guess, in some kind of way as far as mental wise, but as far as a body, we all have heartbeat, we all bleed, we all have the cells running, the veins, blood running through them veins. So, you have to find what works for you, man, at the end of the day. I mean, that's basically it. You gotta find what works for you. And like I said, some people might wanna incorporate, I guess, meat or fish. I mean, hey, it is what it is, man. But from what I've learned, consuming animal products made me sick, made me feel like crap. It gave me high levels and made me put on weight on me that it was hard to lose because even though I work out, it was hard for me to shed that weight, even though I work out. And then on top of that, after I work out, I would go back and eat the same kind of food. So it would just defeat the purpose. So I would be working out so much harder just to shed some little bit of weight, but then I turn around and go back and eat the same thing. So it just never really add up. You know what I'm saying? It just never worked for me like that. But once I start changing my lifestyle, change the way I eat, then the weight start falling off and I keep at one weight now. My weight is like 170, 175. I'm always at that weight. Always at that weight. Right? Some videos here. I'm still running. April 9th is recently. Still running. Still doing martial arts. Still feeling good. Like I said, you gotta find what works for you and you have to consume. You have to eat, man. If you're vegan and you're raw, you have to consume. And you need to understand being vegan, there are vegan foods out there that will make you sick. And there are vegan foods that will put bad weight on you. So you can't just be like, oh, vegan, I'm just gonna eat it because it doesn't have any animal products. Yeah, but they have a bunch of other crap in it. If you look at the ingredients, there's a bunch of other crap in there. That's not good for you. Right? Just like all the fried stuff in vegan foods is the same thing, all I guess the fake meat or whatever they're using, which I don't mess with that stuff. Like I said, that stuff, I don't play with all those things. I don't be like eating like all the fake meat and all these things. I mean, I might have a little soy from time to time, a little tofu here and there, but it depends on what kind of tofu it is and soy it is, right? It's not something that I eat every single day. If sometimes I don't touch it at all for like months. There you go, guys. So that's basically it, man. I mean, you just do what works for you, man. Like I said, the vegans that are going back to meat, you have to consume, you have to eat. And not because it's vegan and it's not animal products, that doesn't mean it can't make you sick. Because trust me, it will give you a belly ache. It will make you break out in acne. It will make you feel like crap. Because it's fried up stuff and certain kind of soy and stuff to make the meat out of is just not good for you. So, same thing with the chocolate bars and all these things. There's certain things that you gotta look at in the ingredients, man. And then, as far as the animal products is, I mean, you guys gonna go back to animal products? I mean, hey, it is what it is, man. I found from my journey that eating a bunch of red meat and all these things is all it did was put weight on me, give me hypertension, and gave me bad digestive system. Wasn't able to digest my food properly, and I wasn't able to use a toilet. And I felt sluggish and sleepy all the time. I felt tired all the time. With this lifestyle here, I have to basically stop myself from working out. Sometimes I've been working out for like 2, 3 hours. I'm like, damn, it's time to stop now, man. And just I kept keep on going. That's the problem that I have, It's like it's so much energy. My fingernails are growing long like crazy. My toenails are growing long. Like every time I trim my nails, they grow back fast. My hair is growing crazy long. It's like it's crazy. It's like it's hard to keep them trimmed. It's like they keep growing. Even my chest or everything is just keep growing crazy. And my body is just flowing. My erections, my sex organs, everything is like it's freaking madness, yo. It's like, yo, it's like sometimes when I go to take a piss at night time, I'm like, yo, like freaking major erection. I'm like pissing everywhere. I'm like the frig. That is what I'm dealing with. A lot of people talking about, oh, I guess we're vegan to have what do you call it? Erectional dysfunction or something like that. No, they have erectile dysfunction because they're not getting the right, they're not getting the right nutrients. I'm like, dude, I don't know about that, man. I'm like straight up every single minute. I'm like super erect, man. It's like, I'm like, what the hell is going on? And my hair is growing, my teeth are fine, my teeth don't chip, I eat nuts and seeds and my teeth don't chip anywhere, my teeth are straight. I just need a cleaning and maybe to replace some fillings, right? That's just my lifestyle there. So do what work for you, man. At the end of the day, you know, the environment, the planet is dying, and we all can make a change. We can, you know, work together to make it a better place. But again, boy, it takes all of us to come together. I mean, a few people can, but it takes everybody to come together, man. Because then you have the corporations that's doing their thing, and then the leading corporations are pushing their ingredients, you know, their kind of foods. And then, you know, basically the majority kind of run the show, you know, and the majority of them is not vegan. The majority are not plant-based. The majority are meat eaters. So that's what you're dealing with now. You see what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, you know, you do it for you and you make yourself happy. And anybody else around you that want to come along or walk beside you, it's up to them. But I'm not here to tell you, oh, you suck, you're garbage, you can't do this right. And you know, you need to eat this way. You know, I mean, you do what works for you, man. You know, this is my lifestyle. This is what I do. And, you know, trust me, there is no freaking wonder pill that's going to take away everything. There is no drink that's going to take away everything. Everything takes dedication, take consistency, take hard work. It's not going to happen overnight. So if you're looking for a quick fix, it's not going to happen. If you're looking to go to a doctor and they give you some pill, yeah, it might probably ease the pain or mask it, but it's going to come back. And it might come back harder with some different problems, with some different side effects, which there are always side effects when you take those kind of prescription drugs. So it's just up to you to knowledge yourself and, I guess, find out for yourself. And that's true experience. So this is my journey, guys. And that's what I feel about the whole vegan thing. It's just, you got to consume, man. You got to make sure you do your homework and consume more. And depending on what you do daily in your workout routines or exercising, you have to consume a lot more. I mean, that's just basically it. And my teeth's not falling out, my hair not falling out. If it's anything, my hair is growing more and my nails are growing more, and I have no erection problems, and I feel healthy, I feel good, and I'm keep on kicking and keep on spitting better than I was ever in my whole life. Better. Way better than I ever was from when I started this lifestyle here. Yeah, guys, so that's about it. And yeah, you guys can keep on kicking. Subscribe to my channel. Check out wengetcha.com, which is gonna be the same thing here. Pictures I'm having here are gonna be on my website. So and yeah. Oops.